Heavenly Father, most gracious and high God, Lord, we thank you for this day and for all the things you do for us. Lord, we thank you for the rain you sent our way this week. We thank you for the greening of the trees, the filling of our rivers and our lakes. We thank you for the promise of a harvest this year. We thank you for all that you do for us, God. We come together and we ask that you forgive us where we failed you this week, even this day, and that you allow us grace to do better. Lord, we ask that you strengthen our faith. We ask that you give us wisdom and you give us knowledge. We ask that you reveal the truth to us, God. It's in the name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. I ain't no song leader. For all you people that don't know, we have no piano player. Job's open, pays great. Not really, we don't pay nothing, but you can sit there. We're going to do Amazing Grace. My grandchildren are here, so we're going to have them play. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already His grace hath brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. The Lord has promised good to me, His word my hope secures. He be as long as life endures. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first began. God gave me a recording deal. We all know each other. We all, John, Leland, John. The weather turned south, nobody showed up. So I got these people and y'all. So y'all are finna get it. We do things unconventional for a Baptist church. Baby, can you just, if you want to run around this big room, go ahead. Ain't nobody here to stop you. Liz ain't here to jump on you. Ain't nobody going to say nothing. Just don't be making a bunch of noise and stay off the pulpit, okay? Never mind. Just stay there. Our scripture this morning is going to be from the first part of Psalms 14. And then we're going to get back to our theme of the armor of God. The fool hath said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. They have done abominable works. There is none that doeth good. The Lord looked down from heaven upon the children of men to see if there were any that did understand and seek God. They are all gone aside. They are all together become filthy. There is none that doeth good, no, not one. Have all the workers of iniquity no knowledge, who eat up my people as they eat bread, and call not upon the Lord? That's kind of a hard scripture, but I just wonder if that is this generation. Quite literally, I wonder if it's us. Because we allow them to say there's no God. We don't try to stop them. We don't invest ourselves in proving them wrong. And we should. Do we do good works for the sake of good works? Or do we do good works for the sake of God? It's supposed to be for God. Everything we do is supposed to be for God. Where are you going, buddy? When God, Yah, looks at us, what does he see? Are we seeking God? Do we understand that Yah is the only God? I don't think most of us do. I think the better part of our country, our entire world, has forgotten exactly what God is. Even the good works that we do, honestly, if we think about it, they're not done for the sake of God. They're done to make ourselves feel better about us, to make it look like we're trying to be good people. But very seldom, if ever, are they actually done because... Very seldom are they actually done because they're what God wants us to do. Our good works are supposed to be a reflection of God in us, not us in God. It's got to all be about God. Say hi. We have given up on the knowledge of God, the true knowledge of God. Instead, almost the entire, all the televangelists and stuff I see, well, not all, a large portion of them, maybe even all to some degree, feed their congregation a bunch of lies. And the congregation eat them up. And the congregation spreads those lies. And those lies become a misrepresented truth. They actually think they're doing the right thing by getting people into the house of worship and swelling the ranks. One of the beliefs is that if you can get the people in, eventually they will see the truth. How are they going to see the truth if nobody's saying the truth? If all you do it is spewing lies and feel good, and what are they going to hear? That's all they're going to hear. I don't like to preach on hell and damnation. Well, you drop that. You want to go get it? Take it to Daddy?
No.
Nope. Oh, your brother is going to get it. There we have grandchildren. Hey, go sit with Daddy, buddy.
No.
Nope. Okay, well, you're going to miss the show. Daddy's going, or Papa's going to do some funny stuff in a minute. Why don't you go see what, sit with Daddy so you can see it? Okay?
No.
Okay. She runs my life. I'm owned by a 30-pound female and a 60, what are you, 65-pound? 65-pound boy.
63.8,
actually. Kids are the stuff, ain't they, man? I'm telling you. Anyway, yeah. Preachers, if y'all got a preacher that you want mad at somebody so you can hear him cussing on some redneck or whatever, show him this video. Preachers, quit lying to your congregation. You're sending them to hell. That's not where you're supposed to be trying to get them to go, okay? It's that simple. If y'all catch me lying to you about something up here, y'all better call me out. Because that is my biggest fear, is that I will misrepresent God up here. Having said, yes, I will take the pulpit. I don't get a second chance now. I have to be right. I have to tell the truth. We are still stuck on the first part of the armor of God because God won't let me let it go. The first part of the armor of God is the truth. It's the first thing. It ain't no stinking belt. It's the first thing you put on. It's your underwear. It's to get all your personal business out of the way of God. So you can put everything else on that you need and it'll work. The first thing you do when you're getting ready to play football or whatever is you gird yourself up. I'm not going to say the word. I might because I'm me. But it's a jock something to get stuff out of the way. And those really tight little shorts you wear playing volleyball and stuff. It's not to get the men in the stands. It's to protect stuff. Quit feeding people a bunch of lies. The truth is not a belt that you throw on after you've got everything else. The truth is the first thing that you need. If you don't have the truth, you don't have anything. I was going to try to gird myself, but I'm not going to stand up there and do that. I researched. I spent hours and hours and hours and hours and hours finding out what girding is. Girding is not wrapping a sash or a belt or a piece of leather or whatever around your waist. It is literally every ancient civilization had a different way of doing it, but they all basically come up with the same thing. You covered yourself and strengthened your core so you wouldn't throw your back out and so stuff wouldn't get in the way. It's that simple. Now then, we're going to jump over to where's the whole armor of God at? Anybody know? Everybody should. If the weather hadn't scared everybody off, everybody would be like, Ephesians chapter 6. Okay.
Somehow made it up there.
All the Bibles made it up there? Well, you don't, here, hey Tyler, take him this one.
Oh, you mean the one that, you know, started?
Started out down there, yeah, that one. She wants to understand God, and she's got her a Bible.
Like
she's
six.
A baby, or six or seven or however many. How many Bibles y'all got open? All right, Ephesians chapter 6. Verse 13, wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with the truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness. Truth and righteousness together. Because you can't have one without the other. You cannot be a righteous human being unless you know the truth. If you're being fed a lie, it's a lie. Right does not have a lie in it. A lie does not have right in it. A lie is a lie is a lie. The end. So, In order for you to achieve the righteousness that comes from God, because within us there is none, you have to know the truth. Now we're going to move on. And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. The word gospel, does anybody know what that translates to? The word that they always repeat is gospel. It's the good news. The good news of peace. The good news of peace in the armor of God is the good news that we have a Savior that will give us peace within ourselves for all the things that we know we've done against man and God. Because if you do something against man, you've done it against God. And it's not that hard to come up with something to do against God, because we are men and women. We're humans. It's just the way it is. And above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. I'm going to point something out here. You got... Your underwear. Your body armor. Your shoes. Why would you put on your body armor before you put your shoes on? You can run in bare feet. It's kind of hard for somebody to break your rib cage if you got your breastplate on. Okay? But if you run into somebody, if you're playing football, you ain't got your pads on, somebody spears you, it's going to hurt. But if you put, I don't know. Just saying. And then, but you got all this stuff, and the last thing, the last two things that the armor brings up, what were they again? Salvation. And the Holy Spirit. It goes in that order. First, you got to know the truth. Then you have to start trying to be righteous. You have to become righteous, which is not easy. You have to know what the rules are. That's what it's saying. Know the truth, know what the rules are, start trying to do it. Understand that there is a way for it to work. That's the shoes. Then you've got faith. Faith that you are on the right path. If your faith is in the wrong thing, then, baby, those are going to fall. I got a stack of Bibles here like you would believe. I'm going to put them, when she's gone, I'm going to put them on the floor. If you have faith and you don't have the truth, what's your faith in? Does anybody, how do we know, if we don't know the truth, how do we know what spirit we're listening to? There you go. It could just as easy be the prince of the air instead of the king of the universe. And we're supposed to be listening to the king, not the prince. It's that simple. We could be listening to the lion that's roaming around trying to consume and destroy or whatever, as opposed to the Lion of Judah, which is seeking to rule our lives in a way which allows us to become more than angels. We have to know who we're listening to. Therefore, we have to have the truth. Then our faith becomes founded in what is real. Our faith becomes something that is real. Our faith then has the power to shut down everything the devil throws at us. Now here comes the visual aid. There was supposed to be a young man here, and I was going to let him try to pull this bow back. This is just a longbow. It is really not that easy to put the string on. I shoot a 50-pound recurve. I can shoot it pretty good. I can barely draw this puppy back. And it will launch an arrow. It will, won't it? It took an arrow. It's scary. I like it. I don't know. Here it's not too bad, but that's, I mean, you gotta, after you get right there, it's like, this 80, 90 pound draw here, people. This is sick. I'm gonna get big. I'm gonna grow up and I'm going to be able to shoot this bow. But here's the thing. It says above all, the shield of faith. Why do you reckon that is? Why wouldn't you carry the shield of faith in front of you? You already got the breastplate of righteousness. Come at me, bro. Because the guy shooting them arrows at you, he's not going to be shooting like this, John. He's going to be standing way back and shooting like that. And they're going to come in from up here. So you kneel and you put the shield above you. You subject yourself to your faith. And your faith is in God. Therefore, you subject yourself to God. It's that simple. That's pretty. Yeah, I got a sword. Your mommy won't be bringing this for nothing. This is a sword. It's a big old sword, too. The sword of the Spirit. Or really big broadsword, whatever. If you got the wrong spirit, if you're listening to the wrong spirit, if you're filled with the wrong spirit, if it's not the Word of God, big sword, then, hey, come here. He wanted to help. Come here.
Okay, question. Why is it when I walk in here, I see you holding a sword?
Because I got a sword. Get up here. Hold on. We're doing something. Here, stand up right there. Do not hit me with this. Here, hold it. Can y'all see him? Can y'all see that sword? Okay. Now, do not hurt me. He has the sword. Can you see that? Yeah, you can see it. He has the sword of the real spirit, the God. He has the spirit of God. I screwed up and listened to the wrong old boy. He wins. No, I'm not going to let you hold that. Little girl wants her own sword. Here, you can have this stick.
Now I'll be back. Okay, don't let her have the stick.
Don't let her have the stick. Okay, here, give me my sword back. Here.
If she has the stick, we'll only be laying down on the floor and all the plates above him are going to be calling out of our head.
Here. Take this to Daddy. I was going to do something with the staff, but blah, blah, blah. We're on. Y'all get it? Do y'all understand the difference? Listening to a lie and not knowing what the truth is can get you in a world of hurt real fast. You're literally going to be going to a gunfight and you're going to be carrying a stick. That I just gave away, okay?
Okay. I tried to grab the stick and she's like, no.
Told y'all this one conventional.
I look at Jewish. I look at Jewish.
The entire New Testament.
And then Sundays.
And we went over this in Sunday school. The entire New Testament.
There's a staff
over there. See, you tell him to be coming to a gunfight carrying a stick. Pow, pow. You're not going to win. Okay, you can have the stick, baby. You can go put it up.
She's spoiled. Yes, she is.
It's not my fault. The Old Testament is the book that the people writing the New Testament referred to all the time. The red letters in the New Testament, the guy that was speaking those words was constantly referring to the Old Testament. This, the Old Testament, That's where you're going to find the truth about what righteousness is. While we are no longer under the law to death, that's the key. We're no longer going to die and go to hell because of the law. Does not mean that we do not have to know what the law says and do our best to put on the breastplate of righteousness. This is where we're going to find the Old Testament, the prophets, the law, the Psalms, Proverbs, is where we're going to find out what right and wrong is. And that's where we need to study. Well, you know, they're going to take my preaching license away. But you know what? I was doing it before I got one.
That one?
Yes, ma'am.
You shopping this one?
Y'all missed all this, by the way. This could have been fun. It's still fun. Well, anybody having a bad time? I got a stick. All right. That went surprisingly well. People, though, seriously, know the spirit you're talking to. Okay? You too, Tyler. I dunked you right up there, man. You got to know the right spirit. If we listen to the wrong spirit, we don't have the truth, or we're not hearing the truth. If we're not hearing the truth, we can't go out and spread the truth. If we don't have the good news, how are we going to tell people the good news? What good is our own salvation if we're hiding behind it, if we're hiding under our own salvation and running around with the wrong sword, cutting people to shreds with it, instead of defending those who might have fallen away, are those who are being lied to. If we're not trying to fix it, then we're part of the problem.
What?
That is about it. Ordinary, if we had a piano player, plug, if we had a piano player, then we would have done like 3 or 4 songs. And then we'd do a couple more songs right now. And then we'd all go eat. But because we don't have a piano player, plug, then we're just going to like pray. And then we're going to go eat. And all y'all are going to have to come in and find places to sit. Because the three of us, we're going to take the whole cafe. We're each one going to go get a whole table all to ourselves. Right? Do not. Todd said he's going to play the piano. Right, if y'all will stand up. Does anybody need any, do we need to pray? Is there anything specific other than we need to keep Dave in our prayers?
Yeah, let's keep Dave in our prayers. And two, I got a truck driver that came in the other night. I didn't catch his name, but his daughter had a baby. And that baby, they found out ain't getting the right sugar in its body. Now this child was just born and ain't getting no sugar in its body. And falling out, instead of being a diabetic, it's reversed.
Reversed.
Yeah. Lord, let's keep that child in prayer.
Microphone, I'm not going to talk into the mic. Somebody broke into our church and stole our security system because their faces were on it, and our sound system.
We still have this, but they don't
work. Yeah, we have. They didn't take the microphone. So.
And I'm using it.
And he's playing with it. All right, we're going to pray, if you please, sir, if you would.
Okay, come on.
She's still innocent. We're just going to let her slide. Heavenly Father, most gracious and high God, Lord, we thank you for giving us a chance at knowing the truth. We thank you for having this book written. We thank you for guiding the hands of all the prophets. We thank you for guiding the psalmist. We thank you for the wisdom you bestowed upon the guy with the Proverbs. We thank you for the need for the letters from the apostles to the churches. We thank you that we have access to the knowledge that we need to gather the truth and to worship you in truth and to follow you in truth, to acquire the righteousness that makes our salvation worth it. We thank you, Lord, for giving us the truth that we can base our faith on, that allows us to withstand everything the other false spirits and false gods and enemies of Christ himself would throw at us. We thank you, Lord, for all the things you do for us. We thank you for the rain. Lord, we lift up this child. You are the great physician. You created this child in the womb. We pray that you would put your hand upon it, send your spirit to it, and make it whole. Lord, we lift up Dave again. We jealously pray that you allow him to continue with us, just like he's always been. For we love the man, and we respect the man. He has been an anchor to us all. Again, Lord, we praise you, and we ask that you go with us and guide us and direct us as we exit this building to serve you. Give us people, God. Give us people that we can be friends with. And if at all possible, Lord, let us all get in the same building at the same time every once in a great while. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Go, church.